So before going to explanation on liquidation or solving any practical problem, let me introduce myself. I am Professor Kishore Nikam from Padma Shri Dr. D.Y. Patil Arts Commerce and Science College, Pimpri, Pune 18. And today I am going to teach you liquidation of companies. What is the procedure for liquidation and how practically liquidation can be handled. For that reason we will solve one practical problem. But before going to practical problem, let me ask you, what do you mean by liquidation? Winding up or liquidation means what?
Winding up means to
gather
all the profit and loss of the company at last and to close up the company.
To close the company, very good, very good. Now you tell me, what are the reasons for closing the company? Because you would have gone through one very important fundamental accounting assumption, going concern concept. Going concern concept is what? Every business has to continue forever. Every company has to continue forever. Clear? That is going concern concept. It has foreseeable future. That is called as going concern concept. Then why close up? What are the reasons for closing up company? See, liquidation also means winding up. Liquidation of companies also means liquidation of a company. You can say winding up procedure. See, company is usually liquidated in specific circumstances, and that circumstances are what? Heavy losses to the company, first reason. When there are successive heavy losses to the company for number of years, then company can be closed. Second thing, when company is not in a position to repay the debts of outside market, if company has raised loan from bankers, if it has liabilities to creditors, or if it would have issued debentures, having a floating charge on assets, floating charge means what? Assets are mortgaged against that debentures, and that is recorded with the register of companies. In that case it becomes a secured loan. When company is not in a position to pay suppliers of the company like creditors, in that case company will be closed, liquidated or wound up. Now second question is what? Who can wind up? Who can start liquidation? Who can start? You tell me. Who will take the decision to liquidate a company? Board of
directors.
Directors. Okay. Any more?
The shareholders.
Shareholders. Very good. See, winding up by members or shareholders. Very important. Shareholders includes preference shareholders and equity shareholders. Especially preference shareholders means the shareholders who possess preferential right of getting dividend from company. Equity shareholders do not have preferential right. If there is a loss to the company in a specific year, equity shareholder cannot claim dividend for that year. Even company board of directors is not under obligation to pay in case of losses to the equity shareholders. But in case of preference shareholders, that amount becomes payable. Already we have discussed types of preference shareholders. If it is cumulative preference shareholder, type of preference share is cumulative, then that preference dividend which is not paid by the company will be accumulated for number of years. And that total amount will be repaid when company will have profits. That is cumulative preference shareholders. But in case of equity, there is no such kind of provision. Accumulation cannot be done for equity shareholders. So if there are arrears for preference shares for more than 3 years, up to 3 years, then preference shareholders can go to the government, go to the court for compulsory winding up. Preference shareholders can file their application with register of companies that wind up this company, we are not getting our preferential dividend as well as we are not getting our repayment of capital. So we want our money back. That can be claimed by preferential holders. That can be claimed by debenture holders. Equally, debenture is a loan taken by the company. Equity shareholder is not a loan. Equity share is not a loan. Equity shareholders are the real owners of the company. That is the difference between preference shareholder and equity shareholder. Equity shareholders are the real owners. Okay, so they cannot claim dividend or they cannot insist for arrears of dividends in case of losses. So shareholders or members can apply to the register of companies for winding up. Circumstances are what? Arrears of dividend. Second is what? Second very important is when company is not being run on sound business principles or company is not following prudent business practices, in that case shareholders can file application with the registrar. If we are of the opinion company is involved, board of directors is indulged into unfair practices, illegal practices, the company, the state of company affairs is managed like sound business principles are not followed, in that case also company can be winding up even in case of profits. So loss is not the only reason. There are many reasons for liquidation. See, in features of company we have discussed, there is a perpetual succession to the company. Perpetual succession means continuity. When company is registered, no company is registered for winding up. Every company is registered as a going concern. But in the journey of that company, in the path of success, sometimes it reaches at that point where it becomes necessary that company should be liquidated due to these reasons. Okay. Now winding up can also be done by creditors. You know creditors? Creditors means what? What do you mean by creditors? Is it asset or liability?
Liability
means what? Financial obligation of company or any person. Creditors means any person who is a supplier of the company of materials, supplier of materials who is not being paid. It may be any banker, financial institution, public financial institution, any saukar, any other person in the market who has given financial loan to the company which is pending. So such person becomes creditor of the company. Clear? The concept of creditor is wide. Anyone who owes some money to the company or to whom company is due to pay, so that person becomes creditor. Now winding up by creditors is what? When creditors are not getting their dues, they are not getting interest, they are not getting installments, in that case they can go to the register of companies. They can apply to the court, clear, that this company should be liquidated and we should get our money back. Okay. Now, winding up under the supervision of court. Winding up under the supervision of the court, that can be possible. See, this is specific case of legal issues when company is indulged in illegal practices, when the state of affairs of a company is being managed in such a way that it is not following sound business principles or prudent business practices. In that case, under the supervision of court, company can be liquidated. Then voluntary winding up. Voluntary winding up is also possible. Voluntary winding up, that we told, winding up by shareholders or board of directors. When company itself is of the opinion that this company should be wound up, some new business should be started, or this cannot be continued as a successful unit due to one or other reasons, In that case, voluntary winding up can be applied. Application will be done to the register of companies. As like registration application is given, application for liquidation can also be given. Okay. And last but not least is the winding up by court of law. Winding up by court. So court undertakes the procedure of liquidation of any particular company. That is winding up by court. Friends, we have discussed many times the structure of corporate laws. The Ministry of Law, Union Government of India, contains Department of Corporate Affairs. Under the Department of Company Affairs, Ministry of Company Affairs, Company Law Board is one committee. Now it is called as Appellate Tribunal. Its new name is Appellate Tribunal. So Company Law Board or Tribunal is a supreme power under the control of Ministry of Company Affairs, which handles all these issues of liquidation of public companies especially. It has different functions like giving directions to the companies, giving circulars, notices to the companies, communicating amendments in company laws through circulars. It can guide to regional directors. Regional directors are under the company law board or tribunal. They are working zone wise, eastern, western, southern, northern, like Mumbai, Delhi, Kolkata and Chennai or Bangalore. So 4 to 5 regional directors, they are following the orders of company law board. Regional directors are connected to district registrars for each district in India, or for some districts regional registrar is given, regional registrar, so register of company. So sequence is what? Ministry of Company Affairs, then Company Law Board or Appellate Tribunal, then Regional Director, and then Register of Companies. So when any company is to be liquidated, that information is passed up to Ministry of Company Affairs in case of public companies especially. Register of Companies will be the first person who will take initiative, initial steps, legal steps to wind up, but it will require a formal procedure to be followed from ministry. Okay, now winding up by court will be authenticated by company law board. Orders will be issued from the Ministry of Company Affairs. And major reason is what? When company is indulged into unfair practices, illegal practices or prudent business practices have not been followed by the company, then winding up by court is compulsory. Clear? Now procedure. Now procedure for winding up. See, procedure for liquidation is what? First is what? Liquidator will be appointed by the tribunal. Now who is liquidator? Liquidator is a professional person who handles the job of winding up. He works on the directions of tribunal, appellate tribunal. He will work as a government representative on that company. So liquidator's appointment will be done. Liquidator may be any qualified person in law who is having 10 more than 5 to 10 years experience, professional person like any chartered accountant, company secretary, any practicing advocate, lawyer, barrister. Any such person will be appointed as a liquidator, or any government officer can also be appointed as a liquidator of company. Sorry. So any such person will be appointed as liquidator. He will visit the company. He will undertake all the assets as well as liabilities. He will conduct a meeting of board of directors first. He will take charge of all assets, all keys. He will take charge of all documents relating to liabilities as well as assets, property documents, bank passbooks, bank statements, books of accounts, accounting records of the company. All these documents he will take into his custody. He will prepare a report of that. He will take signatures of board of directors and he will be officially leading that company for liquidation. So liquidator's appointment is First point in procedure, liquidator's appointment. Okay? Now, once liquidator is appointed, what are the duties of liquidator? What are the duties of liquidator? First duty of liquidator is to follow the directions of tribunal. Second duty is to conduct the meeting of creditors and shareholders. Okay. To conduct the meeting of board of directors to gain preliminary information. Then liquidator's duty is to submit preliminary report within 6 months to the tribunal. Very important. I shall write here, duty of liquidator. You can write the points. First duty is to conduct the meeting of creditors and shareholders. Then to conduct the meeting of board of directors. Then to take charge of all assets and liabilities. To take charge of all assets and liabilities. That is third duty. Then to submit preliminary report within
6 months.
Submission of preliminary report within 6 months to the tribunal. Tribunal means appellate tribunal or company law board. As I said, it represents the Ministry of Company Affairs. So this is very important duty, preparation of preliminary report. It contains the current situation in the company, how much are the liabilities, how much are assets of the company in today's date, clear? And in general, the order of payment is to be decided. That is given in preliminary report. So government or tribunal gets an idea about the actual situation. Then next decision making becomes possible. Then to appoint inspection committee. Then to appoint inspection committee. See, inspection committee or committee of inspection means what? Inspection committee is of 12 members, maximum 12 members. It may include representatives of creditors, it may include representative of shareholders. Clear? All those persons who are related to an industry in some financial or other interest, they may be the members of committee of inspection. And the job of committee of inspection is what? To decide the remuneration of liquidator, okay? To handle the job that was to be done by board of directors before liquidation. All that duties of directors that shall be followed by the committee of inspection till the liquidation procedure is over. Okay? So very important duties on this part. Okay? And to conduct the procedure of winding up or liquidation. Liquidator has to conduct the procedure for winding up. The duty to follow liquidator has to follow the directions of tribunal. Time to time, whatever guidelines or directions have been given by tribunal, that shall be followed by liquidator. And final report to the tribunal. In a nutshell, these are the duties of liquidator. After completing the procedure for liquidation, liquidator has to report to the appellate tribunal. Shall I hope it is understood?
Yes.
Now, these are duties. We will see the actual procedure of liquidation, what happens in liquidation. See, ABC Limited Company, for example, ABC Limited Company, public company, is under liquidation. Liquidator is appointed. He has taken the charge of assets and liabilities. And liquidator came to know, for ABC Limited Company, assets realized means sold. If assets realized are 50 crores and liabilities payable on the date of liquidation are 90 crores. Now what is the problem? If assets realized are 50 crores and liabilities are 90 crores, you tell me what is the problem in front of liquidator? Find out the problem in such case. What will happen? Extra 40 crores, or alternatively, these liabilities include what? Share capital, preference share, equity share, secured loans, unsecured loans, liquidator's remuneration and expenses. Clear? All these liabilities, all these creditors will run to the liquidator. Once they get news of meeting of winding up, they run to the liquidator. Give my money first. I have secured loan. I have security of assets of the company. Pay me first. Debenture holders will say we have floating charge on assets. Pay us first. Preferential holder will say we have preferential right of dividend. Pay us first. Any such bank from whom company has taken loan, that bank manager will come. Pay our money first. Board of directors have given mortgage of the assets with our bank. Problem arises in front of liquidator, whom to be paid first. Out of this 50, because this 50 crores are going to be ended. Khatam ho jayega na wo. So somebody will be there who is not going to get. The job of liquidator is to find out who is that lucky person or unlucky person who is not going to get an amount. So order of preference is given in corporate law. Let me tell you, liquidator is not in a position to make a partiality or to give preference to any such person. He is not in a position. Order of preference, list of preference is provided in company law. Liquidator has to follow that list of preference. He has to follow list of preference. On the basis of that list of preference, he has to make the payment. Clear? I'll write the list of preference that shall be followed by liquidator before making payments, and then we'll go to problem. Okay? So list of preference, you can write. List of preference. So list of preference for making payments in case of liquidation. So first payment will be given to fully secured creditors. Actually legal charges are to be paid first, legal charges first payment. But if company has given 100% security to either of the creditor, then fully secured creditor will be on the top position. Otherwise legal charges will be on the top. So second is legal charges. Third payment will be given to liquidators remuneration. Then liquidation expenses. Or cost of liquidation. Cost of liquidation. It is given on top position. Why? Because liquidator is not paid separately from the tribunal. He is not paid by government separately. He has to recover his own remuneration from this list of preference. So if he will go down, he will not get money. So he comes on number 2, 3 or 3, 4. Liquidation expenses is preferential creditors. See, preferential creditors means what? What is the difference between secured creditors and preferential creditors? What do you mean by preferential creditors? How it is different from fully secured creditors? See, secured creditor means any banker, any financial institution or debenture holder. If 100% security mortgage is given by the board of directors, he is fully secured creditor. Preferential creditor means the creditor who is a government. For example, income tax dues, government dues relating to sales tax. If company has not paid income tax, sales tax is not paid. Other taxes under any parliamentary act that were payable by the company but not paid up to the date of liquidation, that government dues will come under preferential creditors. So very important. Preferential creditors means government dues. Okay? After preferential creditors, secured creditors will be paid. Secured loans. Secured loans includes what? Debenture holders. Debenture holders having floating charge on the assets of the company. Or financial institutions, bankers who have given loans to this company on the basis of some security against the assets or guarantee. After secured creditors, payment will be given to unsecured creditors. Now unsecured creditors means what? Unsecured creditors means the creditors who have not been given security. Clear? Unsecured creditors, simple creditors. Then if any amount remains, then it will be paid to preferential holders. Okay? And then, if anything remains after this, it is having very little chance that something will remain. But if it remains, then it will be paid lastly to equity shareholder. So this list of preference must be followed by liquidator. Liquidator don't have power to change this list. Power to change this list means what? Liquidator cannot do preferential orders payment on number 2 or legal charges at number 6 or number 6 at number 3. It is not allowed. This list is given in company law, it shall be followed. Write down this list properly. So this way, list of preference is to be followed. by liquidator. And while solving practical problem also, we have to follow this list of preferences. When making payments from the assets realization, you have to follow this list of preferences. Shall I hope it is understood?
Yes.
If any question is there, you can ask me relative to procedure of liquidation, types of liquidation, duties of liquidation, direction by tribunal, powers of tribunal, you can ask me. Any question? Friends, basic reason of liquidation that you must understand. When company is not in a position to run as one successful unit, because company is a responsible unit, especially public company. Public company means a company in which public is substantially interested. So it becomes basic responsibility of every government to protect the interest of public. Shareholders invest money in public company. Why? Because they want to earn something, some returns from their investment. So it is job of government to secure general public. So interference by court of law or interference by tribunal or register of companies, it is necessary. It guarantees the smooth conduct of companies. There must be tight regulations, otherwise it is not possible to protect the interest of general public. And liquidation is applied in very critical stage. It is not applied for every company. After the appointment of liquidator, if it is before the appointment of liquidator, if tribunal or government is of the opinion that there is no alternative option for this company to be continued, then and then only liquidator will be appointed. Preliminary report is important. For that reason, it can be rethought whether it can be continued or not. What is the actual position? Clear? And liquidation is conducted for repayment of these people. The maximum possible attempt will be done to repay this list. Clear? Now, I must tell you one thing before going to problem. 50 crores are there in the hands of liquidator. Liquidator will sell all the assets of the company. And after selling that assets, he will start to repay liabilities. Now if he has paid, for example, creditors, legal charges, liquidators, remuneration, expenses, preferential creditors, secured creditors, and amount is ended here, for example, paisa khatam ho gaya uska, jo 50 crore tha, 50 crores are ended. Now in this case, who shall pay these people? Very important question, who shall pay? Liquidator itself. How liquidator will pay? From his pocket? He is a professional person like any salaried employee. He has to just handle the task.
Yes.
He cannot pay from his pocket. Okay. See, there are two concepts. A list contributory. Pay attention here. A list contributories and B list contributories. See, A list contributory means a person who is a shareholder of the company on the date of liquidation and who possess part liquid shares. If Mr. X is having 100 shares of ABC Limited on the date of liquidation, 100 shares Mr. X is having and 100 shares of rupees 10 each he is holding. Out of 10 he has paid 8 rupees. So last call he has not paid. Out of 10, 8 is paid. Means unpaid is what? 2 rupees. So per share 2 rupees is outstanding. That is not paid by the shareholder. So 100 shares into 2 rupees. 200. That 200 rupees is the liability of A list contributor. He has to pay. Liquidator will ask him. He cannot say, I am in the list. I am also waiting for getting payment. Equity shareholder don't have right. Equity holder is the real owner of the company. So he has to pay to the liquidator amount unpaid on the shares. And B list contributory is what? B list contributory means any such person who was the shareholder of the company. Immediately before 1 year preceding to the date of liquidation. If date of liquidation is 31st March 2012, if date of liquidation is 31st March 2012, so immediately before this date, 1 year, the 1st April 2011 to 31st March 2012, within this 1 year, all shareholders, they may have sold their shares. For example, Mr. Y, who was shareholder in October 2011, he sold his shares in November 2011. Liquidation is on 31st March 2012. Even then he will be called. He becomes a B list contributor. So they people will pay to the liquidator. And that payment will be given to maximum attempt will be done to pay this people. We have discussed in features of company. Every company has limited liability. We have discussed this. Limited liability means what? Liability of every member of a public company is limited to the extent of shares held by him and amount unpaid on that shares. So if any call is balance outstanding, not paid by shareholder, then he has to pay that call. And that is A list and B list. Liquidator has power to call from them and make payment to his people. Where this 50 crores is ended, for example. Did you get it? Shall I hope it is understood?
Yes, sir.
So shall we go to problem?
Yes.
Okay. Next one.
Thank you.
we'll solve one problem on liquidation. So that we will understand the practical procedure for winding up of the company. How liquidation is carried on by the liquidator. As we have discussed that different duties liquidator has to follow while conducting liquidation process, and liquidator prepares final statement of account. After the procedure is over, liquidator has to submit this final statement of account to the tribunal. Okay? Now before going to solve the problem, I'll read the problem. I hope all of you have read the question. I'll just read the question and then we'll solve. The Bad Luck Limited went into voluntary liquidation on 31st March 2009. The following is the balance sheet of Bad Luck Limited as on 31st March 2009. On liability side, 15,000 preference shares of rupees 10 each, 1,50,000. 20,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each, rupees 7 paid up are given, 1,40,000. Secured creditors 38,000, which are secured against the stock of pledge on stock of raw materials. Okay. Then preferential creditors 1,200, unsecured creditors are 1,01,800, and total is 4,31,000. In assets, asset side cash in hand 10,000, then stock of raw materials it is 50,000, stock of finished goods is 1,50,000, other assets are 1,45,000, and profit and loss is 76,000. So total 4,31,000 balance sheet total is there. Adjustments, the following assets were realized. Stock of raw materials was realized by bank for rupees 30,000. Stock of finished goods realized for rupees 80,000. And other assets realized for rupees 20,000. The liquidator is entitled to a fixed remuneration of rupees 1,000 plus 3% on assets realized by him only. Okay. Preference liquidation expenses, cost of liquidation amounted to rupees 11,000. And preference shareholders have preference regarding repayment over the equity shareholders. Prepare liquidator's final statement of account. Okay. Now, in this problem, underline the word him only. Liquidator is entitled to a fixed remuneration of 1,000 plus 3% on amount realized by him only. Underline that two words, him only. What is him only?
Very good, very good.
From assets realized, 3% is to be given to liquidator. Friends, assets realized are given to you. Assets realized. Three assets are realized. Three assets are there. First is stock of raw materials.
Stock of
raw materials.
30,000.
It is?
30,000. After that,
stock of?
Finished goods.
How much it is?
80,000.
80,000. And other assets?
20,000.
And other assets? 20,000. 20,000. So total assets realized is how much?
1,30,000.
Total assets
realized.
Friends, I have written this assets realized for what? For calculating liquidator's remuneration. Okay? See, liquidator's remuneration is fixed at rupees 1,000. It is fixed 1,000 and 3% on assets realized by him only. You tell me, what are the assets realized by the liquidator? Or what shall be the liquidator's remuneration? 3% of what? Plus 3% of what? Three percent into what?
Is it
1,30,000? 3% of 1,30,000. Read question carefully. In first line it is given. Stock of raw materials realized by bank. Underline that word, by bank. That is not realized by liquidator. So this asset, stock of raw materials is not considered for liquidator's remuneration. Liquidator has realized only two assets. And that is what? Stock of finished goods.
Goods and other assets.
80,000 plus 20,000.
1 lakh.
So 3% of?
Of 1 lakh.
1 lakh. How much it is?
3,000.
So it is? So liquidator's remuneration is what? Very important. Friends, language has predominant importance in accountancy. You have to read question carefully. If you will not read that two words, stock of raw materials realized by bank, then you will consider this year. And most probable chance of mistake. So read question carefully always. Liquidator has realized only two assets. Liquidator has realized means what? He has appointed auctioneer and he conducted auction sale. By giving an advertisement in newspaper, he conducted auction sale and here he realized 1 lakh rupees only. So 3% of amount of assets realized by liquidator. Got it? This is working note number finishes. Write it. Write down, hurry up. So I shall also write the list of preference here, how liquidator will make payment list wise, the order of preference, list of preference, first. Now I will write, okay, I will take legal charges. Then liquidator's remuneration, liquidation expenses, fourth is preferential creditors, fifth is secured loans. Sixth is unsecured creditors. Then preference shareholders. And lastly, shareholders. This is list of preference friends. So we have to follow this list of preference. As all of us are doing job of liquidator here, we have to make payment by the guidelines of this list. Okay? Now before making any payment, we will go to actual amount in hand. What liquidator is having in hand. Shall I hope it is completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So actual receipts are how much? First is cash balance. Cash in hand. It is given in the balance sheet. How much it is?
10,000.
So estimated value is 10,000.
Yes.
Value realized is also 10,000.
Yes.
Value of cash do not change. 10,000. Then assets realized. Then assets realized. What are the assets realized? Two amount of assets realized. Assets realized. Stock of? Friends, stock of raw materials, what you have written 30,000 here. It is placed for secured loans. In the liability side of your balance sheet, you will see, you will get 38,000 secured loan is there.
Yes, sir.
So that 38,000 loan is recovered by bank by selling this 34. So it will not come in the list of liquidator. So liquidator will not record this 30,000. Very important. We will make separate working note for that. So stock of finished goods. Estimated value as per balance sheet is how much?
1,50,000.
And value realized is how much?
80,000.
Very good. Same way, other assets are also there. Other assets. How much is the value of other assets? 1 lakh. And that are realized for rupees?
20,000.
The actual amount received is 20,000. This column is important. This is book value column. Estimated value as per balance sheet. And this is the column which is giving actual money to liquidator. Now, 80 plus 20 plus 10,000. How much amount is there in the hands of liquidator?
1,10,000.
You can make payment of 1,10,000 here. Very important. While solving liquidation, you must remind how much money is there in my hand?
1,10,000.
So that I could make payment up to
1,10,000.
When it will come to an end, then we'll see what to do. That is magic of liquidation. When it is being ended, then how we will recover money, that we'll see. Now make payments out of 1,10,000 as per the list of reference. You can see here. First payment is
legal
charges. Is it given in the problem? Yes or no? Legal charges is given? No, legal charges is not given. Second is liquidators remuneration. By legal charges, not given. By liquidators remuneration. You can write into bracket working note number 1. Working note number 1. How much remuneration is there? Liquidator's remuneration?
4,000.
As per working note, no need of writing here. Otherwise, you can write in inner column. Fixed is 1,000 plus 3% on 1,03,000. 1 plus 3,000, 4,000 out of column. But we have done working note, you can write here working note number 1. Okay. As per list of preference, shall I write this now? As per list of preference, what is next?
Liquidation expenses.
Okay. Is it given liquidation expenses?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Liquidation expenses. How much it is?
11,000.
So I must write here liquidation expenses. Due to space limitation, I am writing in short, but you write in full.
Yes.
Because shortcuts are for professors only. So you can write in full. Okay. Liquidation expenses how much?
11,000.
As per list you have written. The next is what? Preferential creditors. Yes, it is given 1,200. So by preferential creditors. 1,200. Preferential creditors. Written?
Yes, sir.
Everybody has followed?
Yes, sir.
Next. Come here. Next. Secured loans. Friends, for secured loans, I will make working note. Pay attention.
Yes.
Focus. Working note number 2. It is for
secured loans.
Secured loans. See, in your balance sheet, in your question, secured loans are given for rupees 38,000. Okay? Now bank, which has given loan to this Bad Luck Limited company, it has realized what stock of raw materials against this loan. It is given in question. So less amount realized from sale of stock of raw materials. You can write with me. 38,000 was the actual amount of loan that is recovered less amount realized from sale of stock of raw materials. Now book value of stock of raw materials was 50,000, but it is realized. Realized means sold for rupees 30,000 less 30,000. Clear? So secured loan is remaining 8,000. Now this is unsecured. This 8,000 is
unsecured.
So this 8,000 rupees, 8,000 will be considered as unsecured loan or unsecured creditors. Hence, balance of rupees 8,000, this 38,000 minus 30,000 recovered, balance of rupees 8,000 will be considered as unsecured creditors. Actual unsecured creditors given in the balance sheet are what? 1,01,800. We will add this 8,000 into unsecured creditors. So total unsecured creditors will be 1,09,800. Write on this working note in detail. Sir, I hope it is understood.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Completed?
Yes, sir.
So next is what?
Unsecured
creditors. But friends, before going to unsecured creditors, just take a review on calculator. Take your calculator. We have how much amount here?
1,10,000.
How much payment we have done? 4,000 plus 11,000 plus 1,200.
16,200.
16,200 we have paid. So 1,10,000 minus 16,200.
93,000.
Okay, 93,800. 1,10,000 we have as a liquidator.
Yes,
out of 1,10,000 we have paid 16,200. Balance is 93,800. Pay attention. Malinga. We have unsecured creditors. How much in balance sheet? 1,01,800. And we have to pay 1,01,800.
Yes.
And actual balance in hand is 93,000. So can you record this unsecured creditor here?
No.
I cannot write by unsecured creditor because the amount is short. This you have to take in calculator. Before writing this, just don't copy the list of reference. Take a review in between on calculator whether we would have that much money or not.
Yes.
If not, then make an alternative arrangement for money. Alternative arrangement for money will be done. And given that answer, you tell me, I am expecting from you.
Sir, A contributor.
Very good. Very good. A list contributory. There are shares in the balance sheet of the company. 20,000 equity shares. Of rupees 10 each. Rupees 7 paid up. 10 each 7 paid up means what? Rupees 3 is outstanding. Rupees 3 is balance. Now liquidator will call that money in case of shortfall. 2. Call from contributories. To call from contributories. How much contributories are there? 20,000 equity shares. 20,000 equity shares into rupees
3.
So unpaid amount only can be called up, very important. Unpaid is rupees 3 each. How much money liquidator will get?
60,000.
20,000 into 3 rupees.
60,000.
Now you can pay. Now you have ample balance. Now your balance is 1,70,000. Your final balance is 1,70,000. I can take this total. Why I will take this total? Because the information about B-list contributor is not given in the problem. So final balance in the hands of liquidator is 1,70,000. He can pay maximum 1,70,000 after call from contributor is 60,000. Sir, I hope it is understood.
Yes, sir.
Now we can pay. Now we can pay as per the list. After secured creditors, unsecured creditors. By unsecured creditors. Please write in inner column 1,01,800. 1,01,800 plus balance 8,000. This one, this secured creditors balance becomes unsecured. You are done in working note number 2.
Yes.
So plus balance of secured creditors. That balance is how much?
8,000.
So 1,01,800 plus 8,000. How much?
1,09,800.
Very good. 1,09,800. You can write 1,09,800.
Yes.
Unsecured creditors. Even balance is there. From 1,70,000 balance is remaining. How much is remaining? Just find out on calculator. This balancing figure.
₹44,000
minus this list.
44,000.
So 44,000 is remaining. Balancing figure. Star. Star means balancing figure. Difference. So total 1,70,000. Friends, this 44,000 will be given to preference shareholders. Preference share capital is how much? 1,50,000. 15,000 preference shares into 10 each. So 1,50,000. This amount is less than 1,50,000. So full amount will be given to preference shareholders. It means what alternatively? It means equity shareholders will not get anything. Because this is short balance. It is not fully satisfying preference shareholders. So whatever is remaining, that will be given to preference shareholders. Huh. After making this payment, if some amount would be remaining, then that would have been given to equity shareholders. Otherwise not. Otherwise not. So to preference shareholders. By preference shareholders. And you can say how much amount per share it is distributed? Rupees 44,000 divided by? How many shares are there? 15,000 shares. So 2.9333.
Yes, sir.
2.933 per share. 2.933 per share. Amount is distributed by liquidator to preference shareholders. Clear?
Yes.
So liquidator is able to give up to preference shareholders, but equity shareholders is not given anything in this problem. Sir, I hope it is understood.
Yes, sir.
If any question is there, you can ask me. Any question? So presentation is also very important part, formatting, okay, writing of figures properly, following of list of reference. These are the techniques of solving liquidation. Huh? Please don't change the serial given in list of reference. That is very important. Shall I hope it is understood?
Yes, sir.
I hope that you will be able to handle liquidation practically after going through this solution. Okay, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.